Learning medicine is hard work. Osmosis makes it easy. It takes your lectures and notes to create a personalized study plan with exclusive videos, practice questions, and flashcards, and so much more. Try it free today. Osgood-Schlatter disease is an inflammation of the patellar ligament, right at the point where it inserts on the tibial tuberosity, resulting in painful swelling just below the knee. It's named after two orthopedic surgeons, the American Robert Osgoode and the Swiss Carl Schlatter. So, focusing in on the knee, the proximal epiphysis of the tibia, which is the upper end of the tibia that contributes to the knee joint, has a bony prominence called the tibial tuberosity. This is considered an apophysis, meaning that it's a bony prominence that serves as a site for tendon attachment. The tibial tuberosity specifically serves as an attachment site for the patellar ligament, which is an extension of the quadriceps muscle tendon. When the patellar ligament contracts, it extends the knee. At birth, the proximal epiphysis consists of cartilage, but it contains an ossification center inside. This ossification center starts to ossify, or turn to bone, between the age of 9 and 15, and becomes a bony tuberosity around the age of 18. Osgood-Schlatter disease typically develops between the age of 9 and 15, when the tuberosity hasn't ossified yet, and therefore isn't hard enough to resist traction of the patellar ligament. So this is why the disease is very common in young adolescents who play sports requiring the quadriceps muscles to contract repetitively, causing the patellar ligament to excessively strain on the not yet ossified tibial tuberosity. This results in inflammation of the ligament at the point it inserts to the tuberosity, what is known as traction apophysitis. When the traction is too excessive, it can cause the ossification center inside the tuberosity to crack into tiny bone fragments. Eventually, that results in a more prominent tuberosity or a callus during the healing process. Fortunately, Osgood-Schlatter disease resolves itself, as the ossification of the tuberosity continues as a child grows. Symptoms of Osgood-Schlatter disease are a palpable lump below the knee, which gets very painful with physical activities like running, jumping, squatting, and especially when going up or down stairs, or when the knee gets hit by something.
Ouch!
The diagnosis of Osgood-Schlatter disease is mainly based on inflammation of the tibial tuberosity, which worsens with activity. In addition, an ultrasound can show soft tissue swelling around the tuberosity, and an X-ray might show fragmentation of the tibial tuberosity in severe cases. The treatment of Osgood-Schlatter disease mainly consists of reducing physical activity and applying ice to the tuberosity to reduce swelling, as well as pain medication. However, surgery might be necessary for persisting pain, especially if fragmented bones have evulsed off and get trapped within the patellar ligament. Alright, as a quick recap, Osgood-Schlatter disease results from repetitive traction of the patellar ligament on the tibial tuberosity, causing it to become inflamed, which results in a painful swelling just under the knee. This disease typically affects young adolescents who are active in sports, and its treatment consists of reducing the physical activity, pain management, and waiting for it to heal as the child grows up. Occasionally, surgery is needed. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in a deeper dive on this topic, take a look at osmosis.org, where we have flashcards, questions, and other awesome tools to help you learn medicine. Otherwise, you can always support us by donating on Patreon, subscribing to our channel, or following us on social media.